Hey everybody, this is First Warning Storm Team Chief Meteorologist Brian Benovich. Good Monday morning, everybody. We're talking about the threat for some strong and possibly some severe storms to our west today and then moving into the Carolinas on Tuesday. This is kind of your typical autumn setup. I know a lot of people see this storm and the threat for severe weather and they automatically think spring, but remember, there's a secondary peak in severe weather in the autumn, right around November, when we have the transition from summer to winter. They're very similar setup. Instead of going from winter to summer, this is the opposite transition. So you tend to get strong jet streams and warm, muggy air kind of meeting up. And that's what's happening with this setup. We'll show you the water vapor loop first because it really tells you a lot going on. The first thing you notice, you see this big swath of air here? That's a very strong jet stream. In the southern branch, we've got the northern branch coming down here, and look at this little disturbance. And I'll let this loop a couple times, and you see that little spin in the middle of the country. That's going to interact with these fast moving winds, and that's what's going to create our severe weather threat. This time of year, you don't tend to have a bunch of heat and humidity, and you really don't need it because the wind energy, the amount of shear or wind speed in the atmosphere, is more than enough to make up for the lack of warm, humid air. So when we have ingredients for severe weather, you can make up for a lack of one ingredient by doubling or tripling the other ingredient. In this case, the wind environment is so strong that the threat for severe storms is pretty high. This is the threat for severe storms today. You can see it's centered over the Mid-South, basically from central Kentucky back down into Louisiana and Texas. And I'm going to put the model on here and I'll show you how things will progress today as this line moves into that area. And again, the threat is damaging winds primarily, but there is a tornado threat today. So this is late this afternoon and tonight. Remember, this is going to be 10 p.m. Central Time. You see that squall line moving into the area in red. This is the area we'll be watching for damaging winds. Now, if any cells ahead of it develop, those could be tornadic, but also within the line, we could have some rotating thunderstorms. So that's the threat tonight. Then tomorrow, I'll switch it to tomorrow's outlook. And you can see the threat for severe weather for Tuesday. So this is the severe weather threat for Tuesday. And I know this looks kind of weird. And the reason it looks weird is because there's likely going to be some cooler air trapped against the mountains, which could deter severe weather. And that's the one thing that would probably lean me to believe that the severe weather threat isn't going to be huge tomorrow. But there's so much wind energy, it doesn't take a lot to get a severe storm. So for the Carolinas, the threat is certainly lower than to our west. You can see the line moving in early tomorrow morning. Now, there are probably going to be some strong winds in here. Remember, there might not be any lightning or thunder in these. These are what we call low-top thunderstorms, which means they're not the big monster storms we get in the spring or even the summer. These are low-top, but they were able to tap into that wind energy off the surface, and you can see the storms kind of weakening as they move into the Carolinas. I'll go in closer, and I'm going to turn off the severe weather outlook so you can see this line. So this is 11 a.m. Election morning. You can see this line of storms. It doesn't look like much. And again, I say storms, there's probably no lightning in here, but very gusty winds in there and maybe some minor rotation. And look how it kind of falls apart as it pushes to the east and tries to perk back up. So you can see overall the threat for the Carolinas is much lower than what we're going to see to our west. But again, just to reiterate, here's the severe weather threat tomorrow. The yellow is low and the orange is a medium threat for Election Day. All right, now what I'm going to show you is why the severe weather threat is so high, even though it doesn't look that impressive on the radar or the future cast. It doesn't look like there's that much heat and humidity. I want to show you the wind energy. So what you're looking at here is what we call 500 millibar winds. And what these are the winds about, 5,000 feet off the surface. Now you see this area of strong winds in the middle of the country. That's the area we're watching potentially for damaging winds mixing down to the surface with the storm. So you can see occasionally you saw some purple mixing in there. And watch, I'm going to go through time. And this is basically later today as this energy shifts to the east. Now watch this area here. Remember where the area in red where we had the high severe weather risk? Look at some of these wind speeds just off the surface. These are around 5,000 feet up. So you're looking at winds 70 to 80 miles per hour. We call it sometimes a low-level jet. And when that low-level jet is that strong, 5,000 feet above your head, if you get any kind of shower activity, it'll mix down to the surface. So this is 2 a.m., 3 a.m., 4 a.m. on Election Day. You can see that wind translating. So the mountains in particular of western North Carolina, there's likely going to be some damaging winds just with this low-level jet as it moves to the east. You can see how that line kind of lines up over Charlotte right around 10 to 11 a.m. tomorrow. So if there's going to be some strong winds, and again, these might not be like your typical thunderstorms. It might just feel like a strong cold front, and that's kind of what's going on here. So just a heads up for that potential, because that's some pretty strong winds moving in with that line coming in. So that's the reason we're talking about the severe weather threat. And again, I'm going to throw it back up here just real quickly. You could see the severe weather threat for tomorrow, and I'll back this up one day to show you today's threat. That's today's threat. Much bigger issue here. The reason there's a bigger threat to the west, wind energy stronger, but there's a better chance of getting some of that warm, humid air into the Carolinas. If we get any breaks in the cloud cover, as usual, you guys know what that means. We do not want to see it warm up at all tomorrow. In fact, the fact that we get wedged in with some cool air could be a good thing. Of course, I'll have you covered throughout the next 48 hours. Again, this should not impact voting per se, because this is going to be an all-day thing. And as long as you plan and vote before or after work, I don't think this will have a big issue. It's just going to be really, really windy. Watch out for a lot of leaves flying off the trees. Watch for slick roads, because those wet leaves on the roadway sometimes could be slick. And in the mountains in particular, heads up, strong winds. We could see some trees come down just with that low-level jet I showed you. The 40 to 50 mile an hour winds at the surface, certainly possible as some of those stronger winds aloft mix down. I'll have you covered as we get through this and go through the next 40 hours. Have a great Monday, everybody, and stay tuned for updates.